I'm Ron Donaire, CEO of Intuizi, and I have with me today Sara-Jayne Smith, CEO and founder of the London Data Company, a business founded on the principal vision of helping to create an equitable, informed planet guided by intelligence from data. Sara-Jayne, welcome to the Data Deep Dive.
Thank you, Ron. Delighted to be here.
Well, the pleasure is totally ours. Why don't you tell us a little bit about what you're working on this year? I understand it involves data ethics, data provenance, and data compliance.
Absolutely, Ron, and delighted to talk about some of the projects that we've been working on as a London Data Company. All of our projects feature our three founding principles, which are data ethics, capability growth, and sustainability. So we're able to embed those into each of our projects. I'll start a little bit on the data ethics, really, which is becoming more and more prominent in our work. And we're seeing a lot more in the press recently around data ethics. For us, it's fundamental and goes beyond where we started 5 to 10 years ago, where we were talking about data protection and privacy, and we're much more in the fairness and bias and the transparency and explainability elements of AI. And for us at the London Data Company, that explainability and that transparency is so crucial because we're still in the space of working where it's very much a human in the loop of the AI that we build. We're not building solutions which are making independent decisions. We're building solutions that allow humans to have an insight that they can make a decision in the back of. So that transparency and that explainability to really understand things like where the data came from, the provenance of the data, the age of the data, the quality, the missingness, all of those features, along with what model we've built, how we've built it, what the risks are, what the assumptions are in the model, and ultimately how confident we can be in the outcomes of the model. That explainability piece, that's huge in the work we do and really a fundamental part. It links in so closely to our second founding principle, which is that around capability growth. I know you'll have seen it as much as I've seen it, but the growth in data is huge. And there just are so many opportunities and so many exciting places we can take data. But in order to do that, we need capability. And so we're building capability as we're working on these projects. And by building that capability, it gives us a three-step outcome. Firstly, it can give us some confidence that the models that we've built, the AI that we've built, get to be maintained and supported. And that's crucially important. Secondly, as always happens, more data comes in, business processes change, those models need to be updated, and organizations need to be able to update them so they don't start driving misinformation or even worse, being turned off. That would be a very bad outcome for us. But thirdly, we just want the capability and data to grow up and become more and more key part of all organizations, because the more it does, the more insight we can gain and the more use we can get from our data. And I think that links again really closely to our third pillar, which is around sustainability. You know, we're all producing so much data now, and there's such an asset, but if it's not used, then it's a carbon footprint that isn't required. And you've probably heard, as I have, the figure around, I think the latest estimate around 63% of data is dark data. So data that was created with absolutely no use. So we don't want that dark data. And, you know, there's two outcomes of that. Either you use it, which we'd live to see, or we remove it. And those are areas that the data company works in.
Well, thank you. Thank you for that. Yeah, I mean, I think it's really important, you know, every time I look at the news, there's always some headline about, you know, artificial intelligence, you know, big data, kind of expanding the ability for what we do. But, you know, one of the core principles here that we have at Intuizi is that, you know, the AI that we build and the AI that we use, it really is to augment human intelligence, right? Like there is an AI to HI transition where there's still a human that interprets the data, interprets the story. The algorithms don't have final decision, and it all comes down to all of the inputs, right? Like bad inputs into a model, it has a very, very bad result at the end. And unless you know kind of the different levers that kind of go into that model, you can make some really, really bad assumptions. So I think that like the alignment between the London Data Company and Intuizi's philosophy on data is very, very similar. We talked a little bit about this in our last conversation, but you know, Intuizi uses 100% spare compute to be able to calculate all of the things. So there is not a wasted electron powering computer to process all our geospatial data, which is the kind of like the backbone of what we do. So I think we're very much aligned in that. And I think as companies realize the value of data, it kind of it especially when it's like proceduralized in their businesses, it's really, it really aligns well with like business objectives. Like, you know, as you mentioned, dark data, data that isn't used, that is just generated and stored, that's a cost, right? Like it's a cost of electricity. It's a cost of, you know, AWS EC2 compute time, or it really is not even just like on a human level, like from a business level, it just makes sense to understand where that sits. So you just reduce cost. What company doesn't want to reduce cost where they're not getting any benefit from?
Absolutely.
Yeah. So, okay. So we talked a little bit about kind of like how you guys differentiate in a world where data can very often be seen as a commodity, but what led you to start this business?
So I've worked in technology for many years now on the consultancy side. I've seen things done really well and I've seen things done less well. And I think for me, I enjoy working in the innovative data space where you get to do rapid development, you get to have a hypothesis, you get to prove it, but crucially that you get to ensure that what you've built, if you prove the hypothesis, gets to go into prediction, that we're not spending money on proof of concepts that go on the shelf and don't go anywhere. So the ability to do that and to do it for good, that was what led me to starting it. Wanting to work in a space which is accelerating at a rapid pace and has so much potential to do good was just very exciting for me.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, data is the fuel that's going to power our next, you know, industrial revolution, or, you know, AI revolution, however you want to term the early stage that we are now experiencing right now. There's a fundamental shift, the same way that the internet transformed commerce, data is transforming business practices globally. And it's not even a question anymore. It's of whether it's going to do it. It's how it's going to do it, and making sure we have guardrails in place to be to protect everything from data rights to privacy to just like, as you mentioned, like ethics, like, you know, like, is it ethical to do these things? And I think that at the end of the day, it's really how you apply all of these learnings that AI will hand into the human intelligence that really where it's going to come down to. So with that, that's a good transition into maybe you telling us a little bit about a use case, how a client typically engages with you, maybe what's the, you know, common start point, what's the most common goals that someone approaches you with?
So typically clients engage us with a problem, whether that's a known problem that they are really specifically able to explain it and ask us how to fix it, or whether it's a, we know there's something here, can you help us? And we approach all our work much the same way. We start with the discovery, where we'll look at the data, but beyond the data, we look at the business and the business process. We often find ourselves in that space between the business and IT, able to translate the languages between. And so we work across all of it to understand quite what the outputs that we're looking to do is. Then we'll look at the available data, whether there's a need to go get data, whether it's an engineering problem, whether it's an analysis visualization problem, or whether we're looking to do some predictive modeling with some data science. So really hardening on that, but crucially understanding the insight, the story that they're looking to get from the data. And then we'll work, depending on how quickly we need to deliver results, very much in an agile way, have a hypothesis, prove the hypothesis, fail fast if we need to, but ultimately we're working in collaboration with that customer throughout, making sure they're on the journey, making sure they're able to continue it once we deliver the point we get to.
Excellent. And do you
find...
Go ahead, please.
A lot of our work starts from the point of coming in and doing an audit. Actually, we talk a lot about sustainability and ethics, and it's something we're very much known for. So a lot of companies contact us and say, actually, we've got this model, or we're doing this. Can you have a look? Can you tell us, you know, is it ethical? And sometimes that ethical piece means different things. Sometimes they mean, is it the most sustainable algorithm that I can have? Am I bringing in just the right pieces of data that I need for my model? Am I hosting it in the right the right place. Sometimes they mean, you know, is there a bias? Can we look at the data set that they brought in for it? Can we look at this missingness? Can we create some synthetic data to remove some bias? Sometimes it's that whole explainability piece we talked about from the start and really understanding the provenance of the data. And sometimes, you know, if you're talking about Internet of Things and sensors, you know, if your sensor's outside on a river and it's a rainy day, then you need to know that if that's flowed through to your model, because it will impact on your confidence. So there's all of that, along with the traditional pieces around the privacy and the data protection and the robustness, the security piece. And more and more recently, and I don't know if you've seen this as well, there's a lot more discussions around the accountability and the responsibility of the AI. So who's accountable for it? Who's responsible if it gives good or bad insight?
Yeah, no, I think that makes a lot of sense. I think that, you know, with this type of work that we're in, it really becomes challenging at times when there are organizations that come in with kind of ambiguous requests, let's call it, where you know, it comes in and they don't know exactly what they want, but they know they want to do something in this space. I know, like, one of the things that we've looked at is, you know, like, let's say like AWS, they very easily calculate kind of like carbon emissions on what you're renting, you know, and it outputs that. And that's a nice thing to be able to kind of like to tout. But at the end of the day, you know, there is something that's tied to business and the, you know, the kind of the expansion of doing it in a way that's good for humanity, that it kind of is the underpinning of what you're kind of like bringing out for your clients. Do you have do people approach you and then have any type of you know, either challenging requests or mindsets that you have to like convince them that this is the right thing to do, or once they approach you, they already kind of have that mindset and are set on that path?
I think when they approach us, they've got a belief that they've either got a data problem or they've got a problem that data can solve. Mm-hmm. The bit that's the challenge is working with them to understand how, and you'll have seen this as well, a lot of the time the problem's within their own data, and actually there's a time and a space to dig into that data and understand that data to get to where they want to get to. And there's that piece of working with them and having them understand that they own their data, they need to be part of the solution. And I think we see a lot of that piece, and that's where that space I call between the data team and the business team, where if both of them go in, we know what we want, but it doesn't sit with us. Mm-hmm. And we fit that space quite well, and we've done a lot of work with organizations to bring them together in that space and share that ownership, but also share that outcome. So if we talk about sustainability, your business team very much cares about sustainability, but they may not have the metrics or the understanding to know that they're processing models that have a huge sustainability impact. Mm-hmm. And huge carbon footprint, and your data team know that they're running this model every day, it's got a huge carbon footprint, but they don't know that the business is only looking at the insight once a month. And actually there's a conversation there that could be had that would be better for everyone, but it's about bringing them together. Yeah. So a lot of our work is in that, you know we've got a problem, we know we've got the data to solve it, how do we go forward?
Yeah, it almost seems like you're the bridge or the catalyst for these conversations within an organization. You know, as I talk to my two young daughters, they often need a moderator to be able to settle their issues. And sometimes, you know, parenting and business are kind of very, very often the same in many regards. So thank you for explaining kind of how you work with your clients. So I think that's all the time we have for today. It's been super informative. If a viewer wanted to get in touch with you, how would they do so?
They can reach out through our website, which is ldco.ai or thelondondatacompany.com, or contact us at ldco.ai.
Love it.
Thank you so much for your time, Ron.
Oh, thank you for being on the show. Well, that is a wrap. Join us again next week on another informative session of the Data Deep Dive.